He said, yes, there goes the first question down the drain. Now, of course, boys, the reason you're in town is because you're doing these two marquee dates. The first one you just did a couple of nights ago. Right. Unfortunately, I wasn't there, though I will be at the second one.
He's sick.
That's what he says.
Or working, right? One of the two.
But my spies tell me it went very well. Did you enjoy playing at the marquee?
It was great. It was a lot of fun. It was one of those things where it was kind of the Carnegie Hall of, for like, would be a country western singer, you know? Yeah, it was. Everybody's played there.
Yeah, I mean, Zeppelin, The Who.
And now Great White, of course. Yeah. Was it stranger? Because obviously, since the album came out back in the summer, you've been doing these huge arenas in America, haven't you? Opening the show for people.
Yeah, like, Whitesnake, right?
Right. I mean, is it strange to go from you know, a huge stage like that down to a tiny, diddly little stage like the Marquee?
It's a bit different, yeah, but it's got its advantages too. I mean, you get right in their faces, and you get to be able to get right in the eye, look them right in the eye, and say, hey, you know, good to see you again. It reminds you as well too of, you know, what it's all about, what you're working for. I mean, the stages, when you're on a 60-foot stage, you're looking out people 12, you know, 13 feet back, you kind of lose touch with what all started it, you know, where you came from, the hot sweaty clubs, the griminess, you know, the smoke in the air. It's, you know,
sounds horrible, actually. Give me
no,
the bigger reasons.
It's great though. I mean, it reminds me of sex.
Now that we're on the subject, let's get straight down to the bone. What do you actually do for entertainment on the road when you're not playing?
I think I just said it, didn't I?
Yes. That famous three-letter word, yes.
Yes. Whatever we can get away with, actually.
Right.
You know, there's really not much time. You spend a lot of time sleeping and trying to get your rest.
Now, I'm going to pin you down on this because, I mean, Great White do have a reputation for being a bit of a party band, don't they? And yet you were just saying that while you're on the road, you do try and sort of keep yourself in shape.
Yeah, I do. I let them party for me, see.
What about you, Michael?
No, I take care of myself as well.
Yeah? I don't believe a word of it.
Don't believe a word.
Let's have some music. This is Great White and Save Your Love. Great White and Save Your Love. Kind of gets you... Well, somewhere anyway. Yeah.
Excuse me.
Actually, I must ask you, because obviously most of the bands we have on the show, they're not terribly good at writing ballads, let alone releasing them as singles.
Maybe it's the smoke. Yeah.
What made you decide to go with a ballad as your single?
This actually was the third single in the States. So it was, you know, it was one of those decisions where the song we felt really strong about. I mean, to us, it's a really, you know, good tune. Really good tune.
It's
the smoke, man. I didn't put this stuff in here.
So tell me, what happens now? I know you're going to do this other marquee date. You're not actually going to be playing. Boo! You're not actually going to be playing in Europe, are you, on this visit?
No, we want to come back as soon as possible, though. We'll do a full-fledged tour or at least a festival or something like that. We got the one marquee show, and we go back to the States for Christmas.
Resume in January with Whitesnake.
Of course, it's Christmas.
I was hoping I'd stay here. I could save some money instead of spending it on presents. I mean, send them tour T-shirts or something like that. Here's a program, Mom.
What will you do for Christmas? I mean, you know, what a Great White do for Christmas? That's what I like.
Get a great drunk. I'll be celebrating because, I mean, I'm a very obsessive person as far as taking care of myself on the road goes. Then it's exactly the opposite when I get off the road. Most people go on the road, you know, I mean, they party and they go off tour to stay in shape. Exactly the opposite of me. I go home and I just trash myself. It's all over.
And then, of course, you start again in America in the new year with Whitesnake.
Yeah, January 22nd, Nassau Coliseum.
Whitesnake, who everybody tells me the biggest band in America now, you know, I mean, is that true?
That is true, yeah. They are the numero uno, head honchos.
Does that make it harder for you to go out and play with them? Does that mean that it's harder for you to...
Hell no, it makes it a lot easier, man. Yeah. Gotta worry about nothing. The stadiums are packed, the shows are sold out. Both the bands are just kicking butt, so, you know, it's great. It's a great combination. They're calling it the Great Whitesnake Tour.
Really?
Sorry, Dave.
Thanks for putting this one.
All right, well, listen, Jack Russell, Michael Lardy, thank you very much for coming on the show.
My pleasure.
Do come back and see us you come over and tour Britain and Europe. We'll remember that, won't we? And have a good Christmas as well.
You too. I'm home.
Come on, say. Yeah. Johnny's just the best. Ain't all the ever working, I couldn't care less. You know I ain't got no money, cause I ain't got no money. Pulled up, no goodbye. Now I'm still swimming and living high and high. So don't come around me. Now I'm bringing me down. To keep it alive, remove, baby, allow me to do nothing but a promise, a talk of it soon. Ain't got no love, but we ain't got enough. Enough, just the enough. I give one all up, it never was enough.
Down on your knees, 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 down on your knees songs for all of you, man. Oh, Rock me to the